Hi everyone. Today I am going to look through a Vogue magazine. This is a September issue. Someone just donated it, so I thought it would make a perfect glossy magazine. I know a lot of people like. This is also features Serena Williams after excuse me, after her tennis announcement that she would be leaving. Hope you can see it okay. I tried to prop it up a little bit. I don't have a great setup here. I'm in my little craft nook, and I think I'll move this closer. Hard to know the best place to put the microphone. I got a new little curtain for my craft nook, as you can see. Oh, this is my favorite color of nail polish. This is a refillable perfume. That's interesting. Anyway, I like that color nail polish. Pink. It's kind of a soft pink. I should have matching. So, as most fashion magazines have a lot of designer advertisements at the beginning, really all throughout, but especially there's like usually 20 pages at the beginning of just full page ads. And now that it's September, we're getting a lot of autumn things like purples and blues. That's interesting. Louis Vuitton. Browns and gold. She's got the sweater stockings, which I kind of like. They're hard to pull off. Helps if you're very slender legs. There's Chanel, here's Gucci. More Gucci. This is top of the Empire State Building. Cosmetics. A lot of more cosmetics. It's kind of interesting, the whole industry devoted to women, especially women, and to men to a lesser degree, but beautification, you know, clothes to wear, cosmetics to put on, how to do your hair, jewelry to wear. It's all about your appearance, and I don't think the same attention is devoted to men. Not that there should be more, there should be less about women's appearance. A lot of pink. Nordstrom. Thursday. Perfume samples. This one has probably about 4 or 5 different samples. This is called Libre. Freedom. Or free. Or freedom. Look at those shoes now. I guess they're boots. I can't tell how far up they go. That looks like maybe, I don't even know how tall that is. 6-8 inches heels? 6 inch? And then there's about like a 3 inch platform. El Bizarro, if you ask me. But that's the style these days. If you're into high fashion, I guess. As you can tell, I'm not I'm not really into it. I'm pretty but I do kind of like looking at it just for fun. Serena Williams in a Gucci exquisite MGO dress. Photographed by Louis Alberto Rodriguez. There's Miranda Brooks in a Gabriella Hearst skirt, photographed by Francois Hollard. I don't know what's going on there. Those shoes are gigantic. Bows made from tin or something. Michael Kors, he was a judge on Project Runway for a long time, but I love that show. In 1954, the expedition. What expedition? 1972, the performance. So this looks like skiers. Okay. The forest. The moon. The unexpected. The mountain. The now. Okay. Contributors, little features on different. There's the magazine. Here's a sort of a schoolgirl combined with Jenna's outfit, I guess. The Good Fight. Here's an article. Last year, Maria Ressa won a Nobel Prize for taking on disinformation and risking imprisonment in the Philippines. Her battle for facts is far from over. Italian lingerie. My sister worked in an Italian lingerie shop in Venice when she lived in Venice for about 6 years. Now, here is George and Amal Clooney. Sample Daisy, ever so fresh. Built around body inclusivity and a sinuous, sensual look that celebrates everyone. That's good. High and dry. What to drink when you're not drinking? A mock martini, an adaptogen aperitif, a sparkling wine. Tamar Adler hosts a tasting to try them all. Crystal Visions. Book out this fall, photographer Jamie Beck shares the story behind her picture perfect V Provençal. That's really pretty. Look at that. Former bank becomes a splendid new hotel. Product line and co-signs from fashion's buzziest designers, Cynthia Harvey is out to reinvent the hair care ritual. Imagine what a shoe can do. To the train, probably like 10 miles, but sometimes the sound really travels. This is about how tennis great John McEnroe, there's a new documentary about him, I guess. He was so young back then, 18-year-old. Crystal Noir, Absolute and Yellow Diamond. Here's a little bit of section on decorating. So it's not all fashion. Here's a restaurant, Manhattan restaurant review. Sustainability, art, and seafood all find common ground. Vanessa Hudgens. She's really cute. She reminds me of, there was a girl when I was in junior college. We kind of became friends and she kind of looked like her. I can't even remember her name anymore. Sketchers. The Foul Drop. Here's new things being introduced. Perfect pumpkin spiced coffee. French Girl Active Skin Care. What is here? This is here. Light there. Poncho shirt, fall boots, Fitbits, throwback low resistance weights are waiting to come back thanks to a very modern makeover. So these are actually little weights you can wear while you walk or bike or whatever. Here's some fiction reviews. Ian McEwan's Lessons. Bliss Montage. Stories by Ling Ma. Less is Lost by Andrew Sean Greer. And Lucy by the Sea by Elizabeth Stroud. Pulitzer Prize. That's kind of pretty. Purple, kind of a lavender, really pretty sweater. Sort of a pale yellow pocketbook. Florence. I have relatives in Florence, you know. My mom's family was from Florence. And some of them are still, oh my god. Okay, are still there. Glasses framed through a hole. White, not white. Some are metallic, some are like clear. The hardest thing, here's the fun feature on Serena. She wanted to say farewell to professional tennis in her own way and in her own words. So Serena Williams sat down with Rob Haskell to compose her thoughts at being at a crossroads between tennis and family, between her future and her past. She's terrible at goodbyes, but this is one for the history books. So there's lots of photographs of her and nice article. It's a pretty dress. Fashion's New World. too. So the 20s are coming back, I guess. Same with that. Definitely harkens back to the 20s. This is all about different designers and what they're featured in the latest runway shows. Gauze. Maximilian Davis. Salvatore Ferragamo. Fashion's new faces. You'll know the names they help launch into the world. This year's 29 finalists span across the United States and Europe, but beyond their mere geography, they reflect the aspirations and values of fashion's next generation. Not just who we will wear next, but what the industry will stand for and believe in tomorrow. So these are, this is like a contest for funding new designers and help them launch their business. Ketanji Brown checks. Supreme Court nominee, or justice, now she's a justice. Going Places, Matthew Blasey takes charge at Bottega Veneta. The result is an artisanal craft taken in a new direction. Okay, looks like wool felt. Go, I show hair for the new season. Garden leave. After an epic search, landscape designer Miranda Brooks and architect Bastian Hallard found the English house of their dreams. All they had to fix was everything. Hamish Bowles reports, photographed by Francois Hallard. So this is like a beautiful old country kind of house. Wow, look at that. It's pretty amazing. Poppies, fennel, and sweet peas grow in their cutting garden. And Sarandon. This is like a very classic dress. It could be from the 50s easily. checks. It's got a neat little sporty zip-up sweater. You can see that. Fall finds. More fall finds. You've got fashion accessories, corduroy tote bag. The slip gloss, essential oils blend featuring apple orchard, fireside flannel, and pumpkin spice, plus a gorgeous sunflower passive diffuser to make your home smell like autumn. There's a shower scrubber. Turmeric harnesses the powers of turmeric to provide a range of products that offer amazing benefits. Here's the end of the feature articles. This issue is like featured fashions. More advertisements. Gavache. Prada bag is in the middle of the dairy section of the supermarket. Okay, whatever you say. Oil of Olay. Native Jamaican photographer Nyla Rochelle has an impressive work of still lifes built around tantalizing color. This dazzling necklace, replete with lozenge-like stones in bonbon hues, was the perfect subject matter. With multicolored tourmaline and beryl stones cut into various shapes and sizes, and strung together with 18-karat gold. This is jewelry for the neck. That's candy for the eye. This is really pretty. I like that. Translucent jewel tones. There's more oil of Olay. More jewelry. Quilt. What is this? Oh, it's a scarf that looks like a, it's in the pattern of a quilt. That's interesting. There's a tiny little bag. Very tiny. It's like 4 inches. Made it through the whole thing.